Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim. Today, the topic which we are going to discuss is purchases. So main learning objectives of this discussion is that at the end of this lecture, you will be able to identify the causes, signs, and symptoms of purchases, its transmission, complications, and how to prevent purchases. And finally, how you can make a diagnosis and how you treat the purchases. So before going to start our lecture, I have made a scenario for you all. So the scenario is a 3-year-old boy has presented to you in emergency with respiratory distress for last 1 day. Mother told you that he had fever and cough for last 5 days. He had runny nose and lacrimation for last 2 days. Mother told you that he had persistent cough in episodes accompanied by vomiting. And on examination, you have found that he is lethargic. His temperature is 100 Fahrenheit and respiratory rate is 60 per minute. You can see the picture. And while you examine further, you have noticed that he has characteristic whooping cough. So the lab investigations which you have ordered, they have shown that hemoglobin is 12 gram per deciliter. Total leukocyte count is 15,000 and platelet are 215,000. In leukocyte count, 80% are lymphocytes. X-ray showed perihilar infiltration and atelectasis. ELISA showed IgM antibodies to Bordetella pertussis. Nasopharyngeal swab also showed the Bordetella pertussis. And on the basis of the above investigations, you have made a diagnosis of pertussis. So now you have seen how the children present with pertussis in emergency and what are the lab investigations that normally you order and you will come up to the diagnosis. So now just to look at the some of its causative organisms, these are Bordetella pertussis, Bordetella parapertussis, Haemophilus haemolyticus, adenovirus and Bronchi septica. Its incubation period is 7 to 10 days and it gets transmitted by close contact and with respiratory droplets. It is more common in preschoolers, infants, newborns, pregnant ladies. Females are at more risk than males and single attack confers lifelong immunity. Its clinical features are, it has three stages that are catarrhal stage for first 2 weeks, paroxysmal stage that lasts from 2 to 4 weeks, and convalescent stage is during the last 2 weeks. Normally, it causes the low-grade fever, vomiting, apneic spells in newborns, and a runny nose, and the more characteristic feature is its paroxysmal cough with a typical whoop. So the three stages that are catarrhal stage is characterized by fever, rhinitis, sneezing, lacrimation, nausea, vomiting, anorexia, and nocturnal cough. The whooping cough, that is its characteristics, come in the paroxysmal stage. Along with that, there is also ulcers. If you examine the oral cavity, there will be ulcer at the frenulum of the tongue. There can be subconjunctival hemorrhage due to persistent coughing, periorbital edema, sweating, and sometimes fits may occur. In convalescent stage, there is cough and vomit stops, appetite improves, and habit of pattern, that is the characteristic cough, may persist for weeks or even it has been seen for months. Complications are, it is characterized, can complicate the respiratory symptoms in which it involves the emphysema, pneumonia, atelectasis, rupture of the diaphragm. It can cause otitis media. Neurological complications involve the intracranial hemorrhage, hemiplegia, seizures, encephalitis, rectal prolapse, umbilical and inguinal hernia, malnutrition, that is due to persistent vomiting. So how will you manage the patient? Just as the basic principle of management is monitoring the ABC, that is airway, breathing and circulation, you have to check the oxygen saturation that should be up to more than 90%, sorry. And monitor the vitals, temperature, respiratory rate, pulse, and blood pressure hourly. Give antipyretics to relieve the fever, antibiotics that involve the erythromycin and clarithromycin, and also monitor the cyanosis and hypoxia and respiratory distress so that any of the complications should be managed timely. How can you prevent? So prevention is by vaccination. There is a series of three shots that is included in the our EPI as well. So it is given at 6 weeks, 10 weeks and 14 weeks in combination with diphtheria and tetanus. There is DPT, and booster shots are given at 4 to 18 months and at 5 years. So this is all about our today's lecture regarding pertussis, and it has involved all the components, and I hope you will get everything from the lecture. And if there is any of the difficulty, you can go through again through this reading material. Thank you.